Yeah, you'll notice my facial hair is kicked back in. And that's another thing you may run into is apparently my body goes back to testosterone pretty quickly. I'm young though, so that may have something to do with it. But yeah, I find it amazing that I'm like two totally separate people when depending on what chemical I'm on. All I want to do lately is just, and I have a short temper, and I just want to show people their flaws and throw it back in their face. The whole world is hypocritical and everyone does everything because somehow they get something out of it, which is a true statement. But seeing the world in strictly those that way, it's not the way I want to experience the world. See, I don't want to deal with this whole emotional thing. I don't like them. I've barricaded myself with many walls I've put around me because that's the only way I can deal with work and life. And I manipulate the whole situation. I used work to bitch about my home life because they're expendable. I use my home life to bitch about work because it's safe. I feel like an angry kid with a magnifying glass trying to pit people against each other. But yes. So anyway, the day of my the day after I got into the country, Monday, I had my consultation with Dr. Sikorn. I went into the examining room. I disrobed from the waist down. He examined the tissue to see how difficult the surgery would or would not be. He explained the procedure and how he saves all the nerves that he can, gets rid of most of the erectile tissue with the exception of a bit toward a clitoris, saves the scrotal tissue and whatnot. And yeah, tomorrow's my big day. Very fluttery inside. I think that's the best I can really express it. I've seen many interesting and fascinating things in Thailand, which I hope to bring to you at a later point in time, if I have enough energy. Later on, sometime tonight, I'm going to be getting shaved, and I'm going to be getting an enema. I'm going to be getting cleaned out. I thought it was interesting the fact that they clean you out using enemas instead of in the States how we use that nasty liquid that you have to drink, that whole big pitcher up. Anyone that knows what I'm talking about knows what I'm talking about. I think I prefer the enema rather than drinking the stuff and waiting for it to suddenly come up on you and just, you have to hurry up and make that dash to the bathroom. And then I won't be able to eat anything after that point. Which, okay. I really, really wish I had a cigarette. When you walk into the support clinic, what will happen when you get to the airport is there'll actually be a person there to greet you. I'm just totally bouncing around, I apologize for that. And they'll have your name on a sign and everything, and so you will get driven right to the hotel. And I think think the next day they'll come by at a certain time. They'll give you an envelope. You know, when there's a porn girls first picks you up at the airport. And it'll have the time for your appointment, for your actual consultation with the porn. And all the girls are so friendly. They really are. They're really nice. But there's several day trips, and luckily I was able to go on one of the day trips before my surgery, which my day trip was to the beach house. And I got to hear a lot of the girls bitch about their surgery, which I'm sure I probably will too, and how much pain they're in, and what they do to dilate and actually get their full 7 inches of dilation. So yeah, and I thought, I found that very comforting. So anyone that has the opportunity, sign up to actually go on the day trip to the beach house. Because it really gives you a chance to talk to the girls that have just recently gone through what you're about to go through. Yeah. I know this is going to be really long. It'll have to be broken up into several different sections. So I got an informational packet the same day of my consultation, stating that, you know, for the first 3 months, I am to be dilating at least twice a day, and probably even after that. And if you don't dilate daily, you run the risk of losing inches of depth. And yeah, and it'll be really hard to get it back, so it's very important that you dilate daily. I'll be showing you my dilators later, and probably even walk you through exactly what you have to do in order to dilate. I'm going to be in the bed for several days. 7 days before I even am able to dilate. Because I'll be packed full of gauze. But yeah. It's finally gonna happen. It was a long road, but finally gonna have what so many women take for granted. And all the pain that I'm about to experience, that I fully know I'm about to experience, seems worth it.